Warning, the following video contains math. If you are allergic to math, shut up and watch it anyway. Math is cool. Okay, story time. Warframe has had sorties since December of 2015. Originally, sorties had seasons, kinda like Nightwave, with some evergreen drops like potatoes and some rotating weapon parts like the Dera. That went on for almost a year, and also like Nightwave, the seasons kept getting longer and longer. In November of 2016, they reworked the sorties to their current fixed drop table, at the same time Rivens were added to the game. This was exactly 5 years ago today. At the time, I decided it would be fun to track my drops, because I am a huge nerd. So I started a spreadsheet, and filled it in, every day, for 5 years. I've been doing this longer than I've been making Mandacord tunes. The rows are split up by week, columns are split up by drop. I've combined Rivens into one column, same thing with boosters. I skipped a few days over the years, mostly at the beginning, before I figured out how to run Warframe on my MacBook. Bootcamp isn't great, but it works. I'm also tracking updates because the drop rates have changed over time. We didn't even have published drop rates until 2017. Since then, as they've added new Riven types, that drop rate has slowly gone up, at the expense of Kuva. The last change was update 24, 2.5 years ago. Anyway, this is what my full dataset looks like in all of its glory. You can see the drop rate for Rivens and Iotans used to be very different until sometime in 2017. To make things easier, for the rest of this video, I'm just going to be looking at my results since update 24, the last time the drop tables changed. Here's what that looks like. I'm not sure what was going on at the beginning, but it evened out over the long run, which is kind of the point. On a long enough timeline, your luck should approach the published drop tables. But does it? How can we tell? Well, we can do what's called a chi-squared test. The Greek letter chi, squared. Now you know what it means. Basically, this is going to give us a percent chance that the drop rates are correct based on my results. There are some caveats, though, which we'll get into. To do a chi-squared test, you need two sets of data, the observed results and the expected results. For the observed results, I've done some spreadsheet magic to add up my totals for each drop since a particular update. For the expected results, we're going to take each official drop rate and multiply it by the total number of drops. And do that for all of them. It's how much of each thing I got versus how much of each thing I should have gotten. For grins, I'm also going to calculate the observed drop rate. That's just the number of stuff I got divided by the total. It looks pretty close, right? Let's find out how close. We need to calculate the chi-squared statistic. Here's the formula. Okay, that looks scary, but let's work our way from the inside out. We have O sub I, which is the observed value. Let's just pick the first one. Minus E sub I, which is the expected value. Let's subtract the corresponding one. And all of that squared. All right, parentheses squared. And divide by that expected amount again. So the Greek letter sigma here is telling us two things. The subscript I on these variables means repeat the calculation for each element in the set. Repeat. And once we have that, add them up. There we go. 12.8792. Okay. So what the hell does that mean? Before we get to that, we need one more thing. Degrees of freedom. This is a fancy statistics term that basically means how many independent variables are in our data. We have 10 bins, so that means we have 10 independent variables, right? Well, almost. If you know the value of the first 9 bins, then you automatically know the last one because it has to add up to the total. The last bin isn't actually independent. With 10 bins, we only have 9 independent variables, so 9 degrees of freedom. I'm going to put in number of bins. Anyway, with the chi-squared statistic and the degrees of freedom, we're finally ready to get a meaningful number. Back in the day, you would go to a table and look it up. Here's one on the Wikipedia page. Find the row for the degrees of freedom, and then find the column closest to the chi-squared statistic. In our case, it's somewhere between these two columns, which means the p-value is somewhere between 0.2 and 0.1. These days, we have computers. Google Sheets actually has a function for this. Make sure it's the right-tailed chi-squared distribution. You don't have to know what that means. All right, let's plug in our statistic and our degrees of freedom. There's the exact number, 0.1682, or 16.82%. And finally, if you want to skip all that fuss, Google Sheets has a function to just do the whole chi-squared test. All it needs is the observed data and the expected data. Great, good to have a second opinion. Okay, remember I said the chi-squared test gives us a percent chance that the drop rates are correct. So 17%. That's not great, right? Well, no, it's not, but it's also not exactly proof that they're wrong. If you've read anything about statistical testing, you've probably seen the term p-value thrown around. The normal criteria for a result to be considered statistically significant is a p-value of 0.05 or lower. Our p-value is more than 3 times that. If you were to turn in a result like this in a college lab class, the professor would probably ask you to run more tests. My hypothesis here is that the drop rates are correct, and this isn't a strong enough result to reject that hypothesis. Let's do a sanity check. Let's change my filter and run the numbers all the way back to update 19. Wow, okay. Our p-value is 0.0068. If we were testing the hypothesis that the update 24 drop rate was correct all the way back to update 19, then that's easily a strong enough result to reject that. Still, 17% is not particularly satisfying. So why is it so low? Well, remember I mentioned some caveats with the chi-squared test? Let's take a closer look at the calculation. We want the chi-squared statistic to be small, which it is, except for a couple of results that are blowing us up. I have about half as many reactors as I should, and I have twice as many legendary cores as I should. But that only amounts to about 1% of my total data. It's 14 questionable drops out of 1,000. So the chi-squared test works best with a ton of data, which I have. But it also works best when the bins are more or less the same size, which these definitely are not. The test is basically giving discrepancies in these tiny rare drop rates the same exact weight as discrepancies in the big ones. Luckily, there's something I can do about it. Nobody really cares about the rare stuff. Most of the bitching I see about sorties is either about Iatans or Rivens. So let's keep those two bins and roll everything else into a single bin. The spreadsheeting is getting a little ridiculous now. Same calculation, except now we only have 3 bins and 2 degrees of freedom and 53%. Huh. It's better, but still not what I was hoping for. So what's going wrong now? Well, in this case, it's probably my fault. Have there been days over the years when I forgot to write down a sortie result? And then the next day I was like, oh shit, I forgot to write down yesterday. It was probably an Iatan. Yes. Have there been 15 of those days when it wasn't an Iatan? Maybe. That's only like a 1% error rate. Okay, let's take that out of the picture and just worry about Rivens. I never forget to write a Riven down. 2 bins, one for Rivens and one for everything else. Same calculation, except now we only have 1 degree of freedom. And there we go, 87%. That's a little bit more like it. And if I go back to update 19, 5%. It's just good enough for statistical significance. So maybe some of the rarer drop rates are slightly wrong. I don't know. And maybe I can't count Iatans properly. But I can say with 87% certainty that the Riven drop rate is spot on. At 28%, you can expect to get about 2 of them per week if you do the sortie every day. You'll have dry spells. Here's a whole month where I only got 3. And here's a single week where I got 6. On a long enough run, it all evens out. As for the rest of the sortie drop table, chi-squared test aside, these look really close. Maybe if I do this for another 5 years, it'll be even closer. If you're still here, I've put a bunch of links in the description, including this spreadsheet. Thanks for watching!